I rather confess you that is the very first time in my life that I dare to read my poems in the English language. Translations are by some of my very best friends. They are American and English translations. And this belongs to the New Decade, published in New York and translated by Ben Bellit in the 1 or 2 years ago. I will start having entirely no confidence in my reading, of course. Birth. A man born among multitudes. I live among multitudes, living no matter for history. It is land, the heartland of Chile that matters, where green hair grows dense in the vineyards, the grape lives on light and under the feet of a people, wine is born. Parral is the name for what winter brought forth. The house on the street no longer stands. The mountain untethered its horse's power mass in the depths. The ranges kick upward and a village fell, got by earthquake. The mud walls, the portraits nailed to the walls, the tatterdemalion furniture in shadowy parlors, the silence crosscut by the flies sank back into dust. We are only handful keeping semblance and kinship together, a mere handful, and the wine. The wine went on, living. It climbed up the grapes that a vagabond autumn had scattered. It sank in the wine presses, loading the hogsheads and staining them smooth with its blood, alive in its dread of that terrible earth, naked and vital. It thrived. I remember nothing of weather or countryside, faces or figures, just dust, impalpable dust, a tag end of summer, a graveyard, where once I was brought to search in the gravestones for the sleep of my mother. Her face was unknown to me. So I called to her, hoping to summon her face from the dead, but she stayed with the buried ones. She knew nothing, heard nothing, answered nothing at all, keeping her distance apart from her son, elusive and shy in the dark. That's where I come from. A quake-ridden soil from Parral, a land loaded with grapes, springing up from the death of my mother.